Welcome to the Flow Builder Breakdown video. In this video, we're primarily focused on actions and conditions, which are two really powerful features inside of the Flow Builder. Now, if you haven't watched the Flow Builder Basics video that is right before this one, highly recommend you go and watch that one first and then come back to this. It'll all just make a lot more sense. Now, as I mentioned in that video, we are going to be explaining different elements of the Flow Builder with specific business use case examples. I truly believe that's the best way that you can understand how to leverage this amazing tool that ManyChat has inside of its platform, because otherwise then you're just creating all sorts of different random stuff, but you're not quite sure how it applies to a business. How does it help you make more money? How does it help save you more time and resources, etc.? So actions and conditions are just two things that we want to highlight before then we move into those more complex business use cases and actually stringing together everything that you can do inside of the Flow Builder here, right? These are all the different things, as well as over here in the top right corner with this little blue plus sign, you can see all the different things that you can string together here in chronological order for a user to experience, as well as on the back end. So actions and conditions are two things that are happening technically on the back end here in automation mode, where we can do things like add tags or log certain conversion events for analytics, right? We can do all sorts of really cool and helpful stuff. And then under conditions, we can also check if a user matches certain filters and then decide how we want to personalize the conversation from there. What pathways do we want to take them down based on information that they've given us, or even using information that we actually have from Facebook? For example, really simple, we get the user's gender from Facebook. So if we want to segment males versus females, maybe show something as simple as a different GIF for the conversation, but show a guy in a GIF and then a girl in a GIF, then we could easily do that by adding this condition here. And then when somebody goes to experience this message, like I mentioned, they might get different image, different copy, right? We can be a little bit more girly and fun with the ladies, and then maybe a little bit more macho and whatnot in our copy for the guys. So just one simple example there. And if we wanted to accomplish this, I'll actually show you, let's build it out, that we can add different conditions here, right? So if somebody is male, they'll go over here. If they're female, then let's say that they go over to this message right there. And if they don't match any of these, so maybe for some reason we couldn't bring their information in from their Facebook profile or something happened, then they can get a default message here, this backup option. And that might ask them, you know, which gender they are so that they can actually experience this, or you just might decide to move on from the conversation. So that's how a condition would work. And one other thing that I want to point out before we talk a little bit more about actions as well and how they can play a role is that you can also add multiple conditions. So let's say I wanted to say that if somebody is male and they happen to have a tag that indicates something that they've done in the past inside of the bot, then I could say either they match all of these conditions or maybe they match any of them. And now I can have more people potentially who would go through this because it could be either or. Now with actions, cool thing that we can do is then manipulate what happens inside of the conditions. And when I say manipulate, I really mean triggering certain things or tracking specific information that a user has given us and then use that inside of the conditions. And that's going to primarily happen through tags and custom fields right here. We'll talk about fields later on and you'll see them in specific business use case examples. But just to give you an idea, you know, we could set certain fields and then check what those values are inside of the conditions, as well as leverage other things that we can do inside of actions. And you can set as many actions and as many conditions as you want inside of the flow. I'll see you in the next video.